just to drop a pin. I could let my fit go to the highest bid. Yes, I might drop in. It all depends. Junior high, I was dreaming of a 10. I'm coming clean, though. I mean, not a spec. My girl be serving looks. I can get the chef. Katana sword popping out my walking cane. I'm overseas, my Cali Bay like how was Spain. We getting to the money and you having issues. I bought a and it came with a wetsuit. The Buddha left me without breath. I really am a mess. I'm mooching off my mouth. She be hoping that I take a knee. Yes, I be open to that shrimp life. This is how we live. This is how we exist. Love the kicks and we love the hits. All in the house and I'm wrecking. If I sleep, I'm a wrecking. I'm in my own world. Throw the money up and make my own weather. Mommy playing tether on leather. Money talk, it's a lecture. 80 pointers dance on me, it's electric. Don't hate, I'm still unaffected. Chip on my shoulder, I move undetected. She said, pop the question, the question got deflected. Man, I'm at my board, then my brethren. Let's cut to the chase. It's only on the house when we in the place. My used to lava boys got it up in some flames. Stirring up the cup with my wrist souffle. Shaka Zulu chains with my name engraved. I told you on swing, don't say my name in vain. We bring it to your door like, you rang? Spending all the money, then we watch it boomerang. With the Fendi belt, angry face like, put some gold on my fingers, neck, and shoestrings. Long time no see, that's what they say when they see me, man. I've been going crazy just to stay sane. Hey, your girl went missing, who's to blame? Young whippersnapper with a range. Pause, then I went deranged. Call that hottie on my stage. Long week, but a great day. So it got me like sage. And on me, you should get a raise. On me, yeah, you can hate.
As we go on,
hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's matchup, we've got a pair of running backs who are hoping for plenty of touches come their way. It's Jordan Howard's Bears going up against Forte's Jets.
All right, Larry, thanks. We are across the Hudson from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. A few minutes ago, the hometown Jets were introduced to this sellout crowd, and it's a roar that could be heard across the river in Manhattan. They're set to go as their Jets will match up with the Chicago Bears. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Jordan Howard, and he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Take him down at the 31-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Incomplete. He had his hands on it, but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
And that's a great opening series defensively. You force what should be a three and out on your opening possession.
And great coverage there on third down to force the incompletion to set up fourth. O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. And that one hits at the seven, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Green, 39.
Following the penalty, it's 410. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed, as that's going to move the chains.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football, getting away from one and trying to turn forward and get some yardage, I really liked what he did there.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Here's McCown. Left side complete, Safarian Jenkins. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
3 yards to go on second down. Design run for their wideout. Anderson a first down and more. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield across the 45. A good pickup there of 20 yards. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. First down, this is 14. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. Now a run. This is Bilal Powell. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Back-to-back stops make it third and 10. 10 yards to go on third. It's McCown. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. They came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Now Edwards to kick as he sends it away. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And it'll be first and 10 Bears from deep in their own territory. So the Bears taking the field again on offense, and you know what we love, preseason hype, and Mitch Trubisky gave us that when he started well in the preseason, and now a lot of rumors. Could it be him over Mike Glennon? We'll see.
But when you get drafted number two, yes, the rumors are going to start immediately, despite Mike Glennon getting signed in the offseason to be their number one quarterback. But Mitchell Trubisky has a lot of talent, a lot of potential, and the Bears are coming off of a 3-13 season. He could very well become that guy.
Clock running, under a minute to go in a scoreless first quarter. Now Glennon. The catch is made by Kendall Wright. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. Now a play fake here on first down. And they'll let it go deep for Cruz. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
They decided to take a shot and right down the middle of the field. And really, they didn't give it as much time to develop, did they? They want to take that shot somewhere around the 15-yard mark.
And the defense, able to recover, bat it free. This is Howard on second down, and he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Give him three on the play, and that'll lead here to a third down. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They're going to look to throw. And he's got Miller. He's got the lane, and there he goes. And he just falls short down at the 1-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Take him home. Trying to ram his way in, but they're going to hold him back at the goal line. Call it no gain, and it's going to be second and goal. Trying to punch it in with Howard, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Jordan Howard taking it in from a yard out, and the Bears are in for six. And he's got it to make it 7-0 in favor of the Bears. Barth now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now the Jets offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. And, you know, their previous possession, they were able to move the football, but still wound up punting in the end.
You know, in 2016, Carolina had a 20-play drive that lasted over 10 minutes. And remember how it ended?
In a punt.
Yeah, I mean, how does that happen? You just don't see that happen every day.
And this one maybe not quite that bad, but still, you'd like to have a chance for points if you hold the football that long.
Agreed.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. Leopard. On second down, here's McCown. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. They'll try and get it with Forte. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. On first and 10, here's McCown. Sets up the screen to Forte. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. Only three there on the screen at second down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
Let's go!
McCown to throw on second down. Drops it underneath to Forte. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Give him six on the play, and that'll make it third and one. Of seven. Here's Lachlan Edwards now as he'll kick it away for the second time. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Here's Lachlan Edwards now as he'll punt it away for the second time. We'll come back to MetLife Stadium after this short timeout. Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. The Bears offense now heading back out onto the field. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Second down now after the incompletion. He'll look to throw. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Marcus May with a pick, and they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
And, Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Forte gets the handoff from McCown, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. McCown going to hustle his guys to the line. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. McCown now on first down. That's caught right side by Anderson. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. The Jets on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Working from the gun, McCown. Found his target, it's Anderson. And they do get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Shotgun here for McCown. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Robbie Anderson from 3 yards out. And the Jets are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am, go ahead and tapping out the first half. There's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, whether they want to let their return guy touch it.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Sims. And Sims lost it. He lost the football. And the Jets have recovered.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw them.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick, and his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. And not great starting field position here for the offense. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. On the right side, this is Miller. And now Miller hit, and he fumbles. And it's scooped up by the Jets. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But, hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit.
Here we go now. Watch it now. Hardy, Hardy. No. Check. Patriot.
So after the INT, it's McCown now. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Austin Seferian Jenkins in the final seconds of the first half. And the Jets have taken the lead. So they're able to break the tie just before halftime. Now they just don't want anything crazy to happen on the ensuing kickoff.
Yeah, they want to just add the extra point, get the kickoff taken care of, and get to the locker room with the lead that they fought so hard to get.
Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. Pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Going for the deep ball. He's got a man complete. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Now the offense lining up 1st and 10. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass.
Here we go.
They'll throw now on the final play. He's going to wind up and air it out. And unable able to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. Now the Jets offense about set to take over as they head onto the field. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else. Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
McCown throwing on second. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
On third down, it's Powell. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
I know the game's changed. A lot of people would say it's evolved. Look, I'm a little bit Neanderthal, okay? I love this. No exotic formations, no misdirection. Just line up and run the dog ball, pick up the first down. I love it.
Yeah, third and short, that's what you're supposed to do. Like you said, old school smash-mouth football. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jarrell Freeman, and his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Another nice run there by Jordan Howard, and when we talk about fresh legs, how about 2016? Jordan Howard, the number two rookie rusher. Heck, the number two rusher in the NFL behind another rookie, Ezekiel Elliott.
In the first 3 weeks of the season, he only had 12 carries. So once week four hit, really found his groove. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be second and 11. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. He's got Cruz complete, and he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Down they run with Howard, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is, and really a lot of the time they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance, they're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them.
A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now the Jet offense about to take over as they head out onto the field. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. Here we go with 2nd and 7. They fake the give to Forte. Now McCown. And he's going to be out of bounds right at the 40. 17 yards. For the Jets there as they've got themselves a first down. So here we go, 1st and 10 now. They go play action here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down. So it can't hang on. And as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know. But you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's 2nd down. This is Forte. It gets by him and out into daylight. The 30. Pass the 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Matt Forte, 60 yards. And the Jets are going to add on to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, being on second half, no matter what. Whether it's first 5 minutes, first three, whatever. This was a big score to start the second half.
The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get them down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He's got a man open. It's Cameron Meredith. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A gain of 32 that time.
No.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Lennon hands this one to Howard. And able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. Glennon. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number 3. Back now here on EA Sports. It's Bears football, but they trail on the scoreboard as we get set to bring you the 4th quarter. The offense on 3rd down tonight, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at 3rd and a few inches. Now Glennon. That's complete to Meredith. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first.
No, no, no. Off, off, off.
And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll make this a second down. Now Glennon. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for Zach Miller as tight end there. And it's 3rd and short.
You got to be precise with your throws, especially in this situation. You're inside the 10-yard line going into the end zone. But sometimes the emotion, the excitement, sometimes the decisions just aren't made very well because of that.
Try to run for it with Howard. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a 4th down.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that spot.
And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by Buster Screen. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. He's at the 30. 10. And it's a touchdown for the Jets. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Sheldon Richardson coming in from that outside linebacker spot. He gets him down for a loss of 5. Fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to air one out. They've got his man complete. Touchdown, Chicago. Kendall Wright, an 80-yard touchdown. And the Bears cut into that lead.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post route?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
Barth now to kick this one away. Now it's Lucky Whitehead on the return. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. New York set to take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
McCown now on 1st down. And he's got his man on the out route. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets 1st down. So the offense has it first and 10. McCown. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. A good pick up there, 26 yards. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. They go again with Powell. And they'll get him down right around the 16. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake at the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover, because one more score, and this game's over.
It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Only a yard that time. Second and goal.
This is where coaches have to spend a lot of time going over situations with their...
And he is in. Touchdown, New York. Bilal Powell, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead. And they drew up the counter there. It worked. They're glad they drew up the counter.
And a lot of times what you're trying to do is just simply get the defense moving in one direction. It doesn't take much. Even one step's enough. Get them going in one direction and then cut back against the grain and let your running back finish it off and get the work done.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved the hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue to
move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. 10 yards still left on second down.
All right, here we go. 3-9.
Again, it's Howard. And an alley to run. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
So right now what I'm seeing an offense is just firing off the ball a lot quicker than they can react. And not only that, they're sustaining the blocks, too. I'm seeing guys get 6-7 yards downfield before there's even a hint of contact.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. And this will likely be the last play and wrap things up. And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.
Exactly right. When you start a season, everyone's goal, win all of your home games, split your road games, and you're likely going to be in the playoffs. But when you win at home, boy, what a great feeling that is. You don't even mind if people are at your house when you get home after a win like that.
So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL.